of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Isaiah 11:9.
Welcome to the hour of encounter with Christ.
Here is the mandate of true teaching for liberation, healing, deliverance, total freedom from sin, Satan, and ignorance. The spirit of truth flows with every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Pastor Bayo Oluwayemi
of the World International Christian Center, also known as Wonders Chapel, Ikpotimolu, Osun State.
Prepare your heart for the word of righteousness. Sit, listen, and be blessed.
Fruits of the Spirit. I'm abiding, abiding in the vine.
Hallelujah. Happy new month. God bless you and increase you for good. Nothing hinder your testimony this month. All that God has blessed you with in heavenly places, they are released for you. Whatever is hindering them, their silence and their removal, your blessing become a manifestation. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. I thank God because the word of God is alive. Thank God for the testimony of our sisters. I want you to know that God is your sufficiency. And it can come from anywhere. That's God for you. Praise the Lord. I want to correct something with the teaching today. Because your understanding of something will change your life. I want to teach on topic title. Don't despise your seed. Thank you. Don't despise your seed. Your seed can do great things. And God has spoken to us from even from the nature. And you cannot predict the power of seeds. So if somebody doesn't know Esau's seed,
then he can you ban my rubbing.
The person cannot be far from poverty. And the person will be, it will be difficult for the person to be successful. How big is the seed of maize that is germinating?
Tohu.
A series of maize that is not less than 600 grains. What is the size of yam seedling? That is producing a big tubers of yam. What is the size of a cassava stem? That you will plant. And you get several tubers of cassava. There are several examples like that. And they are not just there, they are talking to you. And God is using them to speak to us. And Jesus came to speak about it too. Matthew 13:31. Don't despise your seed. Tell somebody beside you, don't despise your seed. Another parable put it forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like to a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in his field.
Which
indeed is the least of all seeds, But when it is grown, it is the greatest among the herbs.
Eyi ti o kere ju gbogbo irupin lo, sugbon nigba ti o dagba, o tobi ju gbogbo ewe be lo.
Become a tree so that the bird of the air come and lodge in the branch thereof.
O si digi to be ti won ti awon eye oju orun si wa won gbe ori eka re.
One of the reasons why Nigeria is suffering is that we, as a country, we are despising or disregarding our seeds.
Idi ti orilede Nigeria fi ntiya gege bi orilede ni pe an foju pinti awon irubin wa.
If a family, husband, wife and children,
ti ebi kan baba iya ati omo ati awon omo,
they don't know their seeds,
ti won o ba mo irubin won,
they may struggle throughout life.
Won le ma la kaka.
It's not that they are not praying, no.
Is it we won't gbadura?
I want to show you how important it is.
Mo fe fi bo se se pataki
ho. I will still come back to this passage.
Mo ti pada sori ese oro Olorun yi.
In the book of Genesis chapter 8 verse 22.
Ninu iwe Genesis ori ikejo ese ikeji.
Bible says categorically.
Ibeli so fun wa ni pato.
Say why the hatch remains. Seed time and harvest and cold and heat and summer and winter, day and night shall not cease.
Oni nigbati aye ba wa, nigbati aye yo wa, igba irugbin, igba ikore, igba otutu ati igba oru, igba erun, ojo, ohun ojo, ati osan ati oru ki yo dekun.
Which one come first? Seed time.
Ewo lo wa to sakoko wa igba gbigbin.
Most of you today, you are living on somebody else's seed. That is somebody planting is now what you are harvesting. And if you don't plant, somebody may not be able to harvest. Jesus said in Matthew 13,
he said,
how does the kingdom of God operate?
He said
it's like a seed, a mustard seed. Praise the Lord. He said it's the smallest. But when it is planted, it germinates. It becomes big. The first question is this. Have you identified your seed?
So ti mo irugbin re bi?
Because if you don't identify your seed,
tori to ba mo irugbin re,
you cannot even value it.
O le mo riri re.
Praise the Lord.
Eyin Oluwa.
Have you identified your own seed?
So ti mo irugbin re bi?
Every areas of your life revolve around seed.
Gbogbo agbon aye re o duro lori irugbin.
A lot of people believe that.
Ogbolapo eyan gbagbo wipe
that life happen accidentally. Majorly we in Africa, we think life is a product of accident. No.
Dara.
No.
Dara.
Everything revolves around seed and harvest. Seed and harvest. But do you know the irony of it? There is nobody that is not planting. But the only difference is that few people are conscious and they are planting good things. But everybody is planting. But most people are planting negative things. There is no way you will plant something. Either by utterance, and which is very common. Some they plant carelessly. And you know one thing about seeds. If rodents
ti eku
doesn't eat it,
ti o ba je,
it survives years.
Yo wa nbe lai mo yodun.
They are not planted.
Ti o ba ton ba ti epin.
Major the green seed.
Awon horo.
Do you notice at times when you are selecting your beans?
E mo nigba miran ta ba nsa ewa.
The beans that you think they are not good,
awon ewa ti a ro pe ko dara,
You separate them.
Awo yosoto.
Along with stones.
Atamu okuta.
Then you pour it outside your kitchen.
Awa dasita.
When rain come.
Niba tojo ba ro.
Those one you consider they are not good. What normally happen to you?
Awon tu oro pe ko da won yi. Kini o sele si won?
Eh? If you want to know that the life depends on seed.
To ba fe mo pe igbe aye o duro lori irumi.
And the land
atile
is full of seeds.
O si kun fun irugbin.
Go home.
Lo sile.
Get some sand.
E wa awon iyepe.
Put it inside a container.
E fi sinu agolo kan.
Be pouring water into it.
E ma da omi si.
After some days.
Fun bi ojo die.
What will happen? Don't plant anything.
Ma gbe nkan kan sibe o.
What will come up?
Kini o wu?
Eh? That shows that there is a seed inside that ground.
You too must be a so irugbin wa ninu ile.
I said there is nobody that is not planted.
Ko si enikeni ti ko furugbin.
Some, if you are lazy, it's a seed.
To ba ya ole irugbin ni.
And it will damn, it will generate poverty.
Yo si mu osi wa.
Because your laziness.
Sugbe itori iyole re.
We bring poverty.
Yo mu osi.
That's why the Bible says, a little sleep, a little slumber, didn't it so side thy poverty come.
Oni orun die orugbe die be ni osi re yo se poto.
So when you are lazy, it's a seed.
Nipa to ba ya ole irugbin ni.
But it's a negative seed.
O wa je irugbin to ju alonodi.
Praise the Lord.
Eyin Oluwa.
Bible says a little folding of the hands. Praise the Lord. Some they use all their night to sleep. It's a seed. If you indulge your body, don't care. You know some people, they indulge their body. What did they reap?
Kinaunka.
They reap what we call a kind of disfigure. They are disfigure.
Wow. Kai irupe pe araguara won koni yep koni wa bo se ye ko wa.
Thank you. You know, have you ever seen some people that are overgrown? Some that are that are too fat.
Awon to tobi.
Praise the Lord. Because they can eat anything.
Tori bi won le je oniruru.
They are not different from the bird you put inside cage.
Oh, yato si awon adiye to ko sinu ago.
That hit everything.
Don je oniruru.
You know why that bird is different? The one that they call it a Greek or whatever. It eats and doesn't walk.
E mo pe nto fi yato ni pe on jeun ko rin.
So it's not pouring out the energy.
Ko ma lo awon agbara re.
Compared to other bird that is free range.
Ka di we awon tan awon adiye ta kan da sile.
What are you sowing?
Ki lo npe?
Are you consciously sowing a good seed?
So ti e o ni mo lara na pe o ngbin eso re irugbin rere bi.
Oh, you are so careless.
Abo ti e wa je ni ti o bikita.
This teaching
eko yi
is not limited to church.
Ko wa fun ile ijo nikan, ile ijo sin nikan.
It involves you where you are working.
Ovo o ba o wi ni bi to tin sise.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It involves in your house.
Oba ile re wi.
It involves in raising your children.
Oba bi o se nko awon omo re.
It involves your health.
Oba ilera re wi.
Praise the Lord.
Eyin Oluwa.
What seed are you sowing?
Irugbin wo lo npe.
And whatever a man sows.
On ko un ti e da ba si gbin.
What will happen?
Kini o sele?
Church.
Ijo.
He will reap.
Oni yo ka.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some people think that you just become intelligent. You may be a born genius. But you still need some effort of genuine reading of right material. Some don't sow seed to their intelligence. They don't read. And they keep on wondering, they don't know. How will you know? Are you expecting God will just come from heaven, open your skull, put something there and close it?
Everybody is sowing seed.
Oni gbogbo eniyan lo nfurugbin.
Anger is a seed.
Ibinu irugbin ni.
Malice is a seed.
Iyan e ma ba yan di. Irugbin ni.
Somebody say how does it become a seed?
Bawo le yan so pe ma eni kon bere pe bawo lo se je irugbin.
He sow is a seed. And it gives you a harvest of depressions.
Yo, irugbin ni to ba iti gbin, yo fun ni ikore ikaare okan.
Because anytime you are remembering, you know, most of you don't know that when an issue happens, you are meditating upon it's a seed.
Oba mo mo boya le mo pe ngba tin kankan ba sele te ba tun ro e o mo pe irugbin ni.
He said this.
O so bayi.
Ah, to me.
See me.
And I will not greet him. You are sowing the seed.
Oh,
you are fertilizing it. The irony of it, he might have forgotten that he said it. So the person who said it to you may not be depressed. It is you that is fertilizing. That is now the good ground that is to germinate.
He
said the kingdom of God. It's like a grain of mustard. So I ask you a question again. What is your seed? And I want to send you forth today. To start consciously sowing seed. To a desired future. Bible first said. He said, he that will see a long life and a good day. He said, let him depart from evil. And speaking going. Can you see the Bible? He said, he that will see good day, that will see a long life. Let him depart from evil. People think that it is God that just gives a good
day.
Let me tell you, if you don't have opportunity of traveling out, internet has made life easy for us. Without getting to any country in the world, you can know their culture. If you use African Nigerian style to interpret gospel, you will have a wrong gospel.
Oh, Bafi, Imoye, Alawa Dudu, Abdi Orile de Nigeria, Lati Jise, Irele, Irele Tioto, Loma,
because the understanding of the Bible will be awkward.
So, Mima Oye, Bibeli, Yo Jad, Orikoti.
What are you saying? What is your seed? Are you consciously sowing seed to a future? Ask the person beside you. Are you consciously sowing a seed? So you can have a good harvest. In future. Praise the Lord. I said, don't despise your seed. But before somebody will despise his or
her
seed, something must first happen. He might have understand or know the seed.
Ole tini moye
abi
tini moye irugbin yi.
Because something that you despise, you must know it.
Ogudo mo,
at least a little knowledge of it.
Ogudo ni moye die nipa re.
Let's meet in the book of John.
Eje ke pade ninu iwe Johanu.
Chapter number 6.
Ori ikefa.
John chapter number 6.
Iwe Johanu ori ikefa.
Are we there?
Lati wa nibe.
Verse 5.
Ese ikarun.
Thank you. When Jesus then lifted up his eye and saw a great company come unto me, he said unto Philip, where shall we buy bread that this may eat?
Unje bi Jesus ti gbe oju re soke ti o si ri ope eniyan wa sodo re o wi fun Philip pe nibo le a o ti ri akara la akara ki awon won yi le je.
And this is said to prove him, for he himself knew what he would do.
O si so eyi lati dan wo nitori ohun ti ka re mo ohun ti ohun yo se.
Verse 7 I say, Philip answered him, 200 penny worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little.
Philip da lohun pe akara igba owo ide ko to fun won ti olugurugun won iba fi mu die die.
How many of you are Philippine in the church? Nearly all of us. Go back to that verse 7, please. Nearly all of us. Nearly what? All of us. Church, read verse 7, read it out. Praise the Lord. I said, nearly every one of us. When there is a need ahead, most of the time, we are like Philip, who always says that it's not available, it's not adequate. I get something from this, passage. And this is my own opinion. I think the reason why Philip answered
he did Philip be down there
is that 200 penny worth of bread is not sufficient. That may be what they have as cash at that time.
And that's
why I say it's my opinion. You know, he was so specific about the amounts. He said 200 penny worth of bread can never be adequate. Are you getting it now? Possibly that was the actual cash they have at that time. And that is the life of most of people. You that is hearing me, you want to start business. You've always said this money is never enough. You want to start your building project. This one is not enough. You want to buy that car. You say this one is not enough. You know why? You don't understand the power of seed.
Oh, ni moye agbara irumi.
Eventually,
back on.
Jesus did not use up to 200 penny worth.
Oh no, Jesus ti lo owo toto iba owo ide.
He never used money.
Kolowo.
He only used seed.
Oh, irumi lolo.
Praise the Lord.
Enyi Oluwa.
Do you agree with me?
Se ba mi gbo.
Verse 8.
Ese ikejo.
The 8th verse, please. Thank you. One of his disciples. Are you one of disciples? Nearly all of us are one of disciples. Nearly all of us. One of disciples, Andrew, Simeon, Peter, brother said unto him, Andrew now, Andrew this time around. Philip is the first set of Christians. Why we are now in the stage of Andrew? The Philip said, we said, it's not koleto. Koleto, it cannot be enough. It cannot be enough.
Koleto, koleto.
And I know that some of you, but you are delivered. You will have start your business, but you are like
Philip.
It's not enough. And some of you will have half impact in that building. But you are Philip.
Philip.
If I give 100 naira to this baby, what will he do? If I say I have 100 naira or 50 naira, won't they tell me that I'm crazy? Let me pocket my money. If I drop 1,000, director of admin, 1,000 naira cannot do anything here. You are like Philip.
Oh, that be Philip.
You don't know the power of seed. The seed is so powerful. It can bring the greatest thing. And that's why I define seed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Seed is life. And it's the beginning of all miraculous manifestation. Seed is life. And it's the beginning of all miraculous manifestations. And it is a spiritual thing. How did God create the heavens and the earth? He saw the seed. What was the seed? Let there be light. And there was light. Before it manifested, God said, and the light was good. Praise the Lord. The sister that shared testimony
did
not be conscious when she sowed seed, but she has also sowed
seed.
Because when you say, Philemon, Jesus is our sufficiency. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You may not know when you are talking.
Ole mama gba to nsoro.
Let me tell you, your hot trance, like I have been teaching about some Sunday, can cancel all your efforts.
Yeah, oro re to tele nre o le fagidi gbogbo ilakaka re.
Your hot trance,
oro enu re,
can scatter all the labels.
O le da gbogbo nkan ru.
So let's go to Andrew now.
Eje ka lo sodo Andrew.
No, let's first read what's in verse 9. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter, brother, said unto him, there is a lad here which had 5 barley of loaf and 2 small fishes. What is that?
Okaninu awon omo eyin re Andrew alakunrin Simioni Peteru wi fun pe omokunrin kan be ni yi ti o ni isu akara barley marun.
It's okay. What is that, church?
Kini eleyi?
Eh? Identification of seeds.
Ifarahan irumi.
Andrew was able to identify seeds.
Andrew,
do you agree with me? Andrew was able to what?
Andrew,
identify seeds. But he identified it. He despised it. Bible let us know. But what are they? Among so many.
Kini sugbon kini wonyi je laarin opo eniyan wonyi bi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many times?
Iba melo
have you find the seed of your life?
Lo ti ni irugbin lo ti ri irugbin aye re.
Do you know thought is a seed? Thought.
An pe ero okan irugbin ni.
A good thought in your heart.
Ero rere lokan re.
He said, go and start your bakery.
Lo bere ile ise to ti ma se nkan.
Bread.
Say,
do you know that bread is a seed?
I'm a pe irugbin ni.
Some years ago, long time.
Ni opolopo odun seyin.
Before electric barbing barbing machine was popular.
Ki ero gerun gerun to.
A man was studying the book of Corinthians.
Alakunrin kan.
I think chapter 11, first Corinthians chapter 11.
O nka iwe Corinthians ori Corinthians ni ori kokanla.
And he get to a passage.
O wa de abala kan.
Where he say it's wrong for a man to have long hair.
O ni o buru o boru fun e okunrin ko ni irun to gun.
He said he better shave it.
O ni ba san ko ge.
And the guy here is silent voice.
O wa gbo oro kan lati abenu.
Go and start a barbing salon.
O ni lo bere ise geri geri.
No mind they where to get what he needs.
Konfigi da bo bigita bi ti o ti ri ohun to nilo.
The guy started in Kaduna. He's a member of Living Faith Church in Kaduna.
Arakunrin yi o bere ni ilu Kaduna.
And he started.
O bere.
And from that little seed.
Learn.
It is wanted to have the seed and not to plant it.
It
is wanting. He planted it. What is the planting? He obeyed. It will have remained a seed, a thought in his heart and despised. But he acted on the seed. He took step of faith. He started the barbing saloon. From that single barbing saloon, he got married. He built house. He had his own car. According to the pastor that shared the testimony. Praise the Lord. What is your own seed? How many times have you get the seed? Let me tell you, there is enemy that is attacking seeds. There are plenty.
What
the immediately the thought come to you. The thought will say, who will buy it? Who will buy it? The thought may say, how much will you make from this? Wait for bigger ones. Wait for bigger
ones.
But here in this passage, 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. God use it. Because seed is spiritual and supernatural.
It's
supernatural. How can
You business yam, seeding of yam, and get the tuber later. Can you give me the can you give me the mathematical calculation of it? And at times, even some seeding you plant it, before you plant, they are already decaying. The average calculation of siri of a maize is 600. And what do you need to put on the ground? How many do you need to put on the ground? Can you tell me the mathematics of moving from 1 to 600? And if it is a fertile land, a single stem of maize, do you come with 2 siri? You agree with me? That means you are getting up to 1,200 on one. Life started with seed. We are over 7 billion in the world today. How many people did God started with? Two. And we are now over 7 billion. And we started with how many?
Two.
When God said that there be light, you know how many light that has come from that light. Praise the Lord.
Do you
know how many light? If you know the power of seeds, you will never despise your seeds.
Oh, ni foju binti irugbin re.
Andrew never know the power of seeds.
Andrew mo agbara irugbin.
He identify it.
Only,
but because he doesn't know how powerful a seed is, he despise it. He said, what can this do? Praise the Lord. What can this do? God is changing you today from the attitude of what can this do? Most of you that are doing a particular job now, stop telling me it's a small job. I'm just managing it. Let me tell you, as small as it is, it may be the place where God will connect you to bigger
ones.
Be faithful about it. I told you this teaching is not just for church. In your place of work, what seed are you sowing? Are you sowing seed that the organization will collapse? But you will reap it.
Oh,
it may not be now. Praise the Lord. What seed are you sowing to your family? I mean the family where you come from. Are you the agent of confusion? You are always sowing the seed of discord. Or you are sowing the seed of peace. Peace. Bringing everybody together. Bringing everybody together. Are you the one sowing the seed of backbiting your place of work? Spoiling everybody. You will reap it. Praise the Lord. One of the reasons why I'm always submissive to my boss is that one day will be one day. I will be in that position. Am I praying for what I'm sowing? Seed time and not first time. It's a law. Just like law, gravity, you can't break it. It's a law.